up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Linked lists are among the simplest and most common data structures encountered in coding interviews. Therefore, in this video, we will solve our very first linked list problem of this series while attempting to explain what sentinel nodes are and how they can be used to optimize our solutions. So, suppose you are given the head of a linked list and a value x. What you need to do is partition this list, such as all nodes less than x come before nodes greater than or equal to x. Note that the original relative order of the nodes in each of the two partitions should be preserved. You see, the most intuitive solution to this problem is actually the optimal one, and this solution involves having two lists. See, while traversing the initial given list, we will keep adding its nodes to the first or second list based on the condition relative to x provided by the instruction. Coming up with this isn't the hard part of the problem, but implementing it optimally is. And one way to do that is trying to fetch the first node that should go into the first list and the first node that should go into the second list. Now, these nodes will represent the roots of our sublists. Then we will have to traverse the initial list again to add the remaining nodes to each sublist respectively. To implement this, we made use of these two helper methods. The first one will keep looping over the array and return the first node that has a value smaller than x, and the second one will do the same and return with the first node which value is bigger or equal to x. The nodes returned by these two methods will represent the head nodes of each sublist respectively. After doing that, we will need two pointers to fill these two sublists and iterate over them. Then, while we still haven't traversed all the nodes of the initial list, we need to loop over it and check if the current node's value is smaller than x and the node itself is different than the node returned by the first invocation we made, then we append it to the first list. However, if the node's value is bigger or equal to x and the node itself is different than the node returned by the second method we called, then we append it to the second list. When the whole list is traversed, what remains is linking the tail of the first list represented by the node we are currently at to the root of the first list, which is the node we initially fetched. Do not forget to set the next reference of the last node of the generated list to null to avoid cycles. Additionally, keep in mind that both these assignments may generate null pointer exceptions, so you must make sure that these nodes aren't null before updating both values. Finally, we should return the lower head node of the two lists. However, if that node is null, meaning that all the nodes of the initial list are bigger or equal to x, then we must return the second head node. This was done with the ternary expression in front of you. And that's it. Now, you may have noticed that in this implementation, we might need to traverse the list three times in the worst case to partition it. Well, you can do that, it still works. But you can also make use of what we call sentinel nodes. You see, sentinel nodes are usually empty nodes that help delimit a list by its start or its end. So, in the previous example we had, instead of traversing the list twice to fetch the root nodes of our sublists, we can simply assume that these lists start with an empty, newly created node. Then we can proceed with the same exact logic we previously employed. By doing this, we didn't only improve on the complexity of our previous implementation, but we also reduced our algorithmic code size. Okay, let's bring back our previous implementation and try to improve on it by making use of sentinel nodes. So, if we create two initial nodes, our sentinel nodes, and assume that each one of them represent the start of each partitioned list, then two out of the three loops we previously had won't be needed anymore, as we can now directly append the nodes we loop over to their corresponding partition, represented by a sentinel node. Additionally, we won't need any of these null checks, because we are now sure that we won't be dealing with null nodes. So, after traversing all given nodes, instead of linking the root of the second list to the tail of the first one, we link the next node of the second sentinel node, which is the root of the second list, to the current pointer of the first list, which should be now located at the tail of that list. And similarly to what we previously had, the tail of the second list should point to null to avoid cycles. Finally, in this case, the node to return will always be the next node to the first list's sentinel. Again, no additional null checks are needed. So, to recap, adding sentinel nodes to linked lists will allow us to easily delete from or insert nodes to this list at the beginning or at the end without having to write the different conditions for each one. By doing that, we increased the speed of the operations we're performing and reduced our algorithmic code size. The link to the LeetCode problem we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.